And joining me now, Assemblywoman Valerie Vainieri Huttle of New Jersey's 37th Legislative District and Assemblywoman Amy Handlin of Legislative District 13. Ladies, health care has become such an important issue in the governor's race, including breast cancer prevention. And these are major factors. We want to know what your thoughts are as lawmakers and, of course, as women. First, you.
There is no question that breast cancer still kills women. The reality is that it isn't a political issue and it isn't an advertising issue. It's an issue of life and death for thousands of women watching this show. So it happens. October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. And we need to make sure that the message gets out there that 6,000 plus women in New Jersey are being newly diagnosed with breast cancer every year. More than 1,000 New Jersey women will die of breast cancer this year. Women need to take care of themselves. Women need to get mammograms. And you know what? It's not an issue in the gubernatorial race. It's not an issue. The only reason anyone's paying attention to it is because there was a single misleading, deceptive ad. But women are smart. Women are educated voters. Women are paying attention. And what those women need to hear from us is take care of yourself, get your mammogram, and remember that there's not a single responsible candidate, Chris Christie included, this Chris Christie above all, who doesn't really, really care and want women to have access to all the health care they need.
Do you think it's an issue in the campaign?
I do think that any issue that pertains to women's health is a key issue, and I think mammograms do save lives. Early detection, early prevention is a matter of life and death. And I will tell you, I think as we all know, mammograms are quite expensive. A simple screening mammogram, which is just one photo, is around $300. If you want to go into a screening and diagnostic, which is more angles and more photos, we're talking about $400 and plus. And the last couple of years, I have been getting digital mammograms. And $500. If women cannot afford this, and we free mandates, we will have a large population of women uninsured and certainly will not have proper diagnosis and proper prevention. So I do believe it is an issue. It's certainly, you know, women, whether we are Republicans or Democrats, you know, we cross party lines. This is a fundamental issue for women's health.
Do you think insurance companies should be freed from these mandates?
I think that insurance companies should do the responsible thing, which is, in fact, what is being done in the industry. Every time the insurance industry designs an insurance plan product, they follow the standards of care that are developed and promulgated by medical professionals. And certainly in the area of women's preventive health care, covering mammograms is key to that. And in fact, if you're cynical and you think, well, the insurance companies want to save money by not paying for mammograms, it's in their financial interests to cover mammograms, because it's far, far more expensive to have to cover a course of treatment for someone with breast cancer. So, you know, again, there's nothing in Chris Christie's plan that would advocate for women being denied mammogram coverage. What there is a real effort to take care of the more than 1 million New Jerseyans who right now have absolutely no health care of any kind. They can't afford it. Whether they have mandates in a plan or not, don't have mandates in a plan, is not the centerpiece of that issue. They have no health care at all. But more importantly, again, women need to get mammograms. Valerie's not squeamish. I'm not squeamish. I know a lot of women don't get them because they think they're going to be painful or they don't want to know the results.
And Amy, they don't get them because some of them can't afford them. And I just would like to just clear the record and state the facts. On Chris Christie's website, and I don't want to debate Chris Christie here, but he did have mandate-free insurance. If we went mandate-free, we took all of the mandates that we fought for so hard in the last 15 years, not just New Jersey, but a lot of the states. A congresswoman from Florida just recently, a breast cancer survivor, Deborah Wasserman, just said that if Chris Christie's plan went forward, we would be going backwards to the dark ages. I don't want to debate the plan. I hope that it's not true. But when you start taking mandates out, people are losing that coverage for the most critical procedures that will prevent life-threatening illnesses.
How did you feel about the ads when you saw the ads about the insurance and mammograms?
Lies. Here, it's pretty simple. Here's the reality of the situation. Chris Christie is trying to create a more competitive marketplace for insurance plans, in particular to get bare-bones, no-frills plans so that more individuals can get some health insurance. Now, let's say an insurance company came forward with a plan that not only denied mammogram coverage, but denied any gynecological coverage at all. Theoretically, in a free marketplace, an insurance plan like that could come in the marketplace. I wouldn't buy it. Assemblywoman Huttle wouldn't buy it. You wouldn't buy it. But theoretically, it could be out there. Probably wouldn't last very long. Nor would a plan, you could theoretically have a plan that says that unless you can prove you're on a macrobiotic diet, under this plan, you can't be covered. Well, you know, in theory, that kind of a plan could go out there too, and that one wouldn't last very long either. So the point, again, it keeps coming back to the same thing. Women need to understand. They need to get mammograms. Women don't get them because they think they hurt. I go faithfully for my mammogram every year, and I want to tell everyone who's watching this program, they're not painful. They're not fun. I don't look forward to my mammogram.
But you get your mammogram. So how did you feel about the ads?
I thought the ads, last ad that I saw was pretty factual, Amy. He was speaking actually to a woman who was asking the question, and he did say that her daughter, who was 20, needed a mammogram because of his family history, was the exception. There are no exceptions in this. I do want to say, though, that Amy and I are promoting mammograms, Breast Cancer Awareness Month. I would also like to say that February now is Ovarian Cancer Month. The governor just signed that into legislation. The more that women get to have this information, we'll understand and realize. And we will always make our mammography appointments in October and hopefully get checked for ovarian cancer in February, and all of those gynecological diseases will be preventable. And just so we can say on an up note, there are 2.5 million survivors of breast cancer in New Jersey, and that's saying that we are doing early detection and treatment.
Thank you both for joining us.